discovery, but most important, fun. Every week, we'll explore a topic that's close to your heart and find ways to improve your life and broaden your knowledge on issues rarely tackled in Asia. Right now, we'll give you a sneak peek of what you can expect, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Ever thought of a new look, a makeover? Well, in the first of a three-part series on beauty, we asked Asia's beauty guru, Kim Robinson, for his advice on how to attain a low-maintenance, attractive look and give your hair a new lease on life.
I guess I'll just do it.
Yes, we are.
Certain times in your life you want to change for whatever reason. You know, you've got to feel pretty, you've got to feel gorgeous.
Isn't it great? I love it.
It's simple, it's me.
Kim, the girls are done.
Absolutely.
Let's take a look.
Okay, come on in.
Whoa!
I hope you really like it.
In the next two episodes, look out for makeover tips and expert advice on your makeup and wardrobe. In Asia, more often than not, the pressure of getting married starts right when you leave school or even college, especially for women. But many of us these days are deciding to ignore the biological clock and stay single for much longer, sometimes forever. So how important is marriage these days? We'll find out.
Enjoying life so much these days.
Everybody's looking for the right girl.
Don't really have the time to really meet people.
Is that really true?
They don't have the confidence, you know.
They are so visual.
Hey. I'm straight.
You sure?
I would like to get married. What do you guys want?
It's very difficult to find two people who are willing to commit to each other.
Yeah, when you're younger, you tend to have like a long list of what you want.
The ideal
guy, and then later you go, well, just the top three.
I will try and adapt to her style. Now, will that
you
up for the rest
like
of my life?
Perfect guy. I'm sorry.
Now we take you on a quick tour of this beautiful home in Hong Kong to find out how some basic principles of feng shui can come together and how you can apply these values in your own home. Feng shui is the science of measuring and understanding the flow of qi or energy in your environment. If your qi or energy is unable to flow harmoniously through furniture, room arrangements, or even the colors that you wear, feng shui experts say this could influence the harmony, luck, and positive energy that you need in your life.
We're going to run you through some essential feng shui tips now, recommended by one feng shui master here in Hong Kong.
Make sure that personal spaces are bright and airy, and it's best to have regular shaped rooms.
Plants in front of a gate help prevent luck from flowing out of your home. The same goes for hedges around the fence. Another symbol that could help you is a turtle like this one at the back of your house. It will help protect you and ensure that you always get the support of some very important people. Remember the saying, my luck or business is going down the toilet? Well, here's a tip for you. Remember to keep the lid shut and the door closed. We hope you found those feng shui tips useful, and don't forget to close those toilet doors. Anyway, we hope you enjoyed the show. We'll have more revealing and interesting topics next time round, so we'll see you then. How often do many of us come home after our hard days of work and find out we're just too tired to cook? So what do? We end up eating junk food. We decided to take you to Gaia, one of the premier Italian restaurants in Hong Kong, to meet with owner Pino and chef Paolo Monti to see how they could come up with a creative idea for a nutritious and delicious meal for one. Paolo, what are we making today?
Okay, today we're preparing a salad. We're gonna have some grilled cheese. In this case, we have some mozzarella cheese. We're going to do a dressing out of anchovy, some balsamic vinegar, and olive oil. Something very simple.
And very quick.
Very quick, yes. Nice and brown.
It's not necessarily just the taste, but it's also the nutritional value that's important as well.
Well, exactly.
But, you know, how do you get people to really understand that it really takes 10 minutes?
If every day you prepare half for Sunday or somehow you plan what you want to have during the week, I think that makes it a little bit easier.
Okay, well, thank you, gentlemen, very much.
God, thank you.
I'm dying to actually eat my food. Cheers.
Cheers.
On that delicious note, thank you so much for watching The Lorraine Hahn Show. I hope you can catch us soon so together we can get to the heart of Asia.
Check. Check one.